Couldn't get out. Has that ever happened? We're 30 seconds late, man.
I got held up coming out of the studio.
Neil, I have told you a million times, do not mess around with the containment unit, especially the protection grid.
Will you relax, man? It's for a news story. Figured we could use the publicity.
Hi, I'm April Hunter from Channel 8 News.
Ed Spengler, Paranormal Elimination and Investigation. So, I suppose you're curious as to how the containment unit works.
Actually, yes, I am curious.
Well, it's pretty basic, really. We're all made up of atoms, which are basically electrical particles vibrating and bouncing around. Now, the law of conservation states that energy cannot be created or destroyed. So, when a person dies, their life energy disperses throughout the galaxy to heaven or hell or whatever it is you believe in. But sometimes, for whatever reason, some of that energy sticks around, and that's what keeps us in business.
Harvesting souls.
Electrical anomalies, Miss Hunter. Psychokinetic energy. And with the encoder I built, we can convert those ghosts into a signal, and from there, it's a snap to store them in the computer.
Provided Pavel hasn't crammed the memory full of porn.
Like I said, it's simply erratic residual energy left over when a person dies. We're not talking Dante's Inferno here.
And who are you to decide the fate of humanity's souls?
Well, first off, we bust bad ghosts. And frankly, goblins have killed in the past, making it quite serious.
My colleague is right. Our clients call us when they have a problem. If our work wasn't satisfactory, then we wouldn't get paid.
So what it really comes down to is your money.
Look, don't make me your straw man. We're scientists here. Well, I'm a scientist.
I'm sorry, I'm just trying to be the objective reporter here. Get the facts straight.
Well, then get this straight. Around here, people consider us heroes. We help people in this town, and we do damn fine work.
I believe we have everything we need.
Bye.
Hey! Wait a second! Wait up! I cannot wait to see the footage on this, guys. I think this is gonna make a great story. I think it went really well in there.
Well, you're in luck. Hopefully it'll air tonight.
Very, very cool. Very cool. You know what? You never thanked me for saving your life, didn't you?
Saving my life. You know, if I recall correctly, it was Mr. Spengler that turned off the containment system before it went critical. Anything, you almost ended my life. Come on.
Ouch. Hey, wait a minute. Wait. How about I make it up to you over dinner?
Dinner?
Shut up!
I got a 12-pack with your name on it.
I'd love to, I really would, but I got another interview to do.
Yeah, but is he a celebrity? I mean, come on.
Yeah, he is. I'm sure you've heard of him. Klaus Konstantin? He's been in the news quite a lot.
Yeah, it rings a bell. Mm. So what, you date all your assignments?
No, just the ones that aren't jerks. Come on.
We're here on location near the ancient Egyptian city of Sinopolis, where Dr. Klaus Konstantin and his team have made a remarkable discovery. Tell us about it, Professor.
Well, sir, it would appear that what we have discovered is, in fact, the Amulet of Anubis.
And what is that?
The Amulet of Anubis. It's an ancient talisman fabled to carry the powers of Anubis, the most ancient guardian of the underworld. According to ancient Egyptian beliefs,
it sounds very old.
How many times are we going to watch this tape?
I'm very worried about this story, Neil.
All right, let's hear it.
Well, I've been researching this amulet that Konstantin has recovered. Anubis is an incredibly ancient god, the god of the underworld, according to ancient Egyptian myth. He was responsible for escorting souls through the afterlife to their final judgment. He was also responsible for feeding souls of sinners to Amit, the eater of the dead.
So, what? No heaven?
No anything. Being fed to Amit meant the soul would vanish into oblivion with no further hope of existence.
So, Konstantin can eat souls with this amulet thingy?
Well, sort of. If he figured out how to decipher it, he could open up a gateway to an alternate dimension. The afterlife, or Hall of Two Truths, according to ancient Egyptian mythology.
Bobble. You're just in time. Ed's making another apocalypse prediction.
And we're going to be studying the find at my lab in Denver later this week.
Professor Constantine.
What, you know him?
Okay. Tell you what, you stay here and daydream about Constantine all you want. I'm hitting the bar.
You down?
You buying?
You driving?
It's a deal, comrade. Let's drink!
Do it!
If this talisman actually carries the powers of Anubis, I'd be interested in finding ways to harness them. Perhaps as a weapon? For the good of mankind, of course.
What are you up to, Professor?
Here's the crate you asked for, Professor.
Excellent. Thank you. The Amulet of Anubis. Something I've been searching for my entire professional life. Where are the rest of the crates from the expedition?
They're on their way to the museum.
Well, I'll need some time with this one. I'll bring it back tomorrow. Personally.
All right, whatever you say, sir. Sir? Hey, I don't know if this is something you'd be interested in or not, but a couple of us are gonna go down to Chuck E. Cheese's later on and try to pick up some MILFs.
Some what?
Yeah, you know. There's lots of them that hang out there for some reason or other. Mechanical puppets or something, I don't know. But I didn't really want to tell you, they just asked me to ask you, so you want to do it or not?
Some other time, perhaps. I have a later engagement.
Wow. With a woman?
Himmelquatsch, Donovan Nochmal, of course with a woman! A nice, beautiful reporter woman. Is it so hard to believe that a man like me can find love?
No, no. I mean, yeah, but it's not because you're crippled, all right? It's because you're not very good looking. And no, don't take that the wrong way. You know you're not very good looking. Just look in the mirror, goddamn.
Quiet. I'll see you tomorrow.
All right, whatever. Just stay and fondle your little amulet or whatever. A good time without me.
So, Pablo, tell me what you know about Professor Bubble Boy.
I just don't think he's a nice fella. That's all. Hey, look, we're on television, eh?
Oh, for Christ's sakes, can somebody change the channel in here? See, huh?
Hey. I know what's up. You're sweet on this reporter girl, aren't you?
What? No way, man. Oh. No. Well, sort of.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Why don't you just ask her out?
What the hell do you know about women anyway?
Women just like confidence. Watch this. Hello, lady. I know someone who wants to beat your ass.
Oh, yeah? Who?
My balls.
You're cute.
See?
You gotta be shitting me, man. That's the worst line I've ever heard.
Oh, jeez. Are these crackpots at it again?
What was that, Chief?
These Ghostbuster freaks. They're crackpots. Idiots like...